I'm at least set back. Reporting.
Is that a real tattoo?
I have everywhere.
Do you have an ankle?
No, not yet.
Is that a real tattoo? Or you just painted on with the Sharpie?
No, it's a new one.
Why? What is that for?
And that's all it is?
Just a cross.
What is that for?
Just
to have. Did it hurt?
Yeah, it does. A lot.
Did you see it? For the Dijon fight?
Are these the Dijon?
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna put one up. I'm gonna put one up right here, but I'm gonna do like a frame thing.
You should go to a store called Michael's where they sell those boxes.
You're trying to go to Dez, huh?
Depends on how you want it.
Well, they already won the game, pretty much, right?
Yeah, but he's about to break a big record.
What is it?
Most touchdowns by a Dallas Cowboy receiver, I believe.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that good?
It's all about the Saints right now, Ellie. Five game win streak.
For who?
For the Saints. The best team in the league.
Hold on.
What's up, man?
King Louie in the house.
No está sirviendo?
He just wants his dad.
Get the shit.
I'm not watching that.
How you doing, Django?
Like your shoes.
Django, who's this?
Here,
yeah. Django.
Oh, pero ya lo comencé.
Did you? Django.
So when do you get your car?
Next week.
How random was that? Within 24 hours,
random
you got. That's badass. Okay, how many dates do you think you'll get with your new car?
None.
Mikey, how many dates do you think you will get now?
What?
With a new car.
This sick like that.
How many dates?
Dates?
Yeah.
Oh.
Wherever you go.
Same thing on it?
Yes.
Like that? And play like that?
That's from the Dejan fight?
Yeah, the back. I'm framing one up. The other one, I might give it to my brother.
Do you remember, Mikey? They said you're underdog, that he's Mike Tyson, that he's going to knock you out, that... You have no chance.
Some reporters, some writers, you know. There was some that were being a little skeptic about my return and whatnot. But it's all right.
But it happens all the time. They said the same thing for Broner.
It's good.
It's better to be the underdog.
Yeah. Because then they have nothing else to say.
So your next fight, they're going to say the same thing.
Yep. No matter who I fight. Well, maybe not whoever, but...
Mikey,
you have a simple one, Lucci.
Oh, you're in the diving boats?
Yeah.
I remember.
Hey!
Hey, Che!
Hey, baby!
Hey! Fuck you, Che.
Ted, you a good boy?
Yes, yeah.
Do you remember Robert used to hate dogs at some point?
Yeah, he never liked them. Now he's got two.
One time
he loves them. He loves this one and the other one.
We were at Indian's gym and we had the dog and he ran into the ring.
Oh, I remember that. I think you probably still have that up.
Yeah.
You probably still have that. Want that Pepsi? Yes, I have Pepsi.
Yeah, you know, I feel bad for all these fighters that are fighting this week. Because they look so miserable being here, like they can't eat, can't drink. They're mad.
Did Hickory eat anything? Did you eat anything, Logan?
No, they told me they're going to punish their opponents for this. Hector, you're mad.
Used to it. It's not easy. It's work.
Pepsi's scared, huh?
Damn!
Close to that.
Wow.
Come on.
Oh, that's Fernando. Right, how old was he?
Like 16, I think.
You know, he looks like King Louis in that picture?
Yeah.
Louis, come here. Does it look like you?
He does.
Fernando Vargas when he was a kid.
He was 16, right there.
Yeah.
Take off your hat. Take off the hat.
Look. Just like him.
Look.
Look. But he was a monster back then, Mikey.
16-year-old. He's the youngest to win the U.S. Nationals.
And was
ever
an Olympic teammate of Mayweather.
He was the youngest to win the U.S. Nationals. Now I think they changed the rules to race after 17. He did it when he had just turned 16.
What's your favorite moment with the Big G?
One of my favorite moments with the Big G. I don't know. I mean, it's hard to tell. I mean, you got a lot of good memories, good moments. You know, just hanging out at the house. He used to do a lot of barbecues at the house, gather the cousins and uncles and aunts, stuff like that. The other day was real nice when we did that little party, a little victory party celebration for him, a little retirement party at the house.
That was a good time. He was singing then, right?
Yeah, exactly. You know, like those moments when he's singing, you know, it's something cool. It's hard to tell like one favorite moment. Maybe if I think about something, I probably wish him with like a special moment.
But all jokes aside, he's one of the best trainers, but most underrated, who doesn't get the credit that anybody else in his position, they would have glorified him and said, he makes champions, look at Robert, look at you, look at Fernando, look at other fighters.
Yeah, but you still see the work. The people that I know will give him the credit, and you still see a lot of that transitioning and translating over to Robert's, you know, career and Robert's success in as a boxing trainer. A lot of it has transferred over.
Get him!
Yeah, I'm gonna text Lauren right now.
Have you been a big Cowboys fan always?
Cowboys, bro, since I was like in second grade.
What about you, Payo? Saints?
Saints
and Lakers?
Saints and Reggie.
Reggie. You know, he only likes Reggie Bush because he was with Kim Kardashian.
From USC over to...
No, from Kim Kardashian. That's what he loves. Do you know he was involved in a scandal at USC? And they took away all of his awards because he got bribed?
Everybody gets bribed.
Everybody gets bribed. What's up, Alvin?
Everybody in college.
I became a Cowboy fan when I was like in the second grade because my cousin Renato, he was it was gonna be like my birthday. It was my birthday. He gave me a little sweatshirt.
Is it a Cowboy hat?
It was a Cowboy sweatshirt with I think it was Taz who had the Cowboy star jersey on him, and I think he had like Bugs Bunny on the ground and Tweety Bird like on the ground, something like that.
Yeah.
So it was Cowboys, you know, and ever since then it's like, oh, Cowboys. I like the sweater, I guess. And I've never, and honestly, I was never like following the sport that much. I'd watch it because the rest of the guys would watch. But me, myself, I wouldn't follow. So I wouldn't be considered like a diehard fan. So I'm not like that. But that's the team I support. Recently more, like in the last few years.
To meet them and go
Well, even before that, I started watching more and more. But when I grew up, I wasn't that kid that always watched like...
Like Payo.
Yeah, I wasn't. But I support them. You know, that was the team that I would always cheer for. But now, as I got older and recently, like after my fights and whatever, started following more and more. And now, we got to meet them. And,
do they follow you on social media or something? No, but do they know who you were to play with?
Some guys did. They seen the Broner fight. They had seen the Broner fight. Some of the guys did.
That should have been his.
Okay, what are the chances of you fighting someone at Cowboy Stadium?
Not bad. I actually talked to one of the guys who's in charge of all that stuff.
They were down?
Someone got me in touch with a person. I forget the name. I got the contact info if I look it up, but
they mentioned about it and they said that
could be done in a few fights, you know, just let my name grow a little bit more, get the right opponent, and they could do something like that.
I think that'd be sick. And you come out with a football helmet and a Cowboys jersey. Yeah, the Cowboy Nation's behind you.
Closing in on 5 minutes to go. Redskins need a score quick.
I just take the door and...
Like, are you watching the game? He says, unfortunately.
Why?
He's a Redskins.
Oh, Washington.
He's from Washington.
Okay, what's your pie will be for Halloween if you had to pick a costume for him based on his personality?
You got a costume already?
No.
What should you be, pie?
I don't know.
Mayweather dressed into a cat.
Dressed up as a cat?
Yeah.
What?
Not Felix the cat, the other one. What's his name? Sylvester the cat.
Pio's gonna be... What should be, Pio?
A pin.
A pin.
Chucky. Ted. He knows his name.
Oh!
And then right after
reporting. Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rockin' with the best. Ellie Setback. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition, he abusing them.